Good morning and welcome to St. John the Baptist. We extend a special welcome to newcomers and visitors. If you're new to the parish, please complete a registration form found in the vestibule. Since the beginning of time, God has loved and delighted the people he created to share fully in his love. Despite their repeated rejection and betrayal of him, God's love for his people never ended. In Jesus, and in the giving of his body and blood, God offers us the way to become one with him and know and love him completely. To properly prepare for this Mass of the most holy body and blood of Christ, Corpus Christi, we ask you to please silence all electronic devices. There will be a second collection this weekend for our debt reduction. Thank you for your generosity. Please rise and join our celebration.
Christ, take up thy rest, come with thy grace and heavenly aid to fill. To thee we cry. Most high, thou font of life, change from above,
Good morning, everyone. Thank you for coming out on such a lovely day to celebrate these sacred mysteries. Let us begin in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, we come together this morning to celebrate Corpus Christi, the feast of the most precious body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. And as we do so, we realize that as Catholics, this is what we call the source and summit of our faith, and that is to celebrate the Eucharist, to receive the Lord, body and blood, soul and divinity. So as we prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries, let us acknowledge our sins. You were sent to heal the contrite. Lord, have mercy. You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy. You intercede for us at the right hand of our Father in heaven. Lord, have mercy. And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting. And now we give honor and glory to the Father as together we proclaim, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sin of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Let us pray. O God, who in this wonderful sacrament have left us a memorial of your passion. Grant us so to revere the sacred mysteries of your body and blood that we may always experience in ourselves the fruits of your redemption, who live and reign with God the Father in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Exodus. When Moses came to the people and related all the words and ordinances of the Lord, they all answered with one voice, "We will do everything that the Lord has told us." Moses then wrote down all the words of the Lord, and rising early the next day, he erected at the foot of the mountain an altar and 12 pillars for the 12 tribes of Israel. Then, having sent certain young men of the Israelites to offer holocaust and sacrifice young bulls as peace offerings to the Lord, Moses took half of the blood and put it in large bowls. The other half he splashed on the altar. Taking the book of the covenant, he read it aloud to the people, who answered, "All that the Lord has said, we will heed and do." Then he took the blood and sprinkled it on the people, saying, "This is the blood of the covenant that the Lord has made with you in accordance with all these words of his." The word of the Lord. I will take up the cup of salvation and call on the name of the Lord. I will take up the cup of salvation and call on the name of the Lord. How shall I make a return to the Lord for all the good he has done for me? The cup of salvation I will take up, and I will call upon the name of the Lord. I will take up the cup of salvation and call on the name of the Lord. Precious in the eyes of the Lord is the death of his faithful ones. I am your servant, the son of your handmaid. You have loosed my bonds. I will take up the cup of salvation and call on the name of the Lord. To you I will offer a sacrifice of thanksgiving, and I will call upon the name of the Lord. My vows to the Lord I will pay in the presence of all his people. I will take up the cup of salvation and call on the name of the Lord.
A reading from the letter to the Hebrews. Brothers and sisters, when Christ came as high priest of the good things that have come to be, passing through the greater and more perfect tabernacle not made by hands, that is, not belonging to this creation, he entered once for all into the sanctuary, not with the blood of goats and calves, but with the blood of his own, thus obtaining eternal redemption. For if the blood of goats and bulls and the sprinkling of a heifer's ashes can sanctify those who are defiled so that their flesh is cleansed, how much more will the blood of Christ, who through the eternal Spirit offered himself unblemished to God, cleanse our consciences from dead works to worship the living God? For this reason, he is mediator of the new covenant. Since a death has taken place for deliverance from transgressions under the first covenant, those who are called may receive the promised eternal inheritance. The word of the Lord.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. The Lord be with you. Our reading is a reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Mark. On that first day of the Feast of Unleavened Bread, when they sacrificed the Passover lamb, Jesus' disciples said to him, "Where do you want us to go and prepare for you to eat the Passover?" He sent two of his disciples and said to them, "Go into the city, and a man will meet you, carrying a jar of water. Follow him. Wherever he enters, say to the master of the house, 'The teacher says, where is my guest room, where I may eat the Passover with my disciples?' Then he will show you a large upper room, furnished and ready. Make the preparations for us there." The disciples went off, entered the city, and found it just as they had told him, and they prepared the Passover. While they were eating, he took the bread, said the blessing, broke it, and gave it to them, and said, "Take this. This is my body." He took a cup, gave thanks, and gave it to them, and they all drank from it. He said to them, "This is my blood of the covenant, which will be shed for many. Amen, I say to you, I shall not drink again the fruit of the vine until the day when I drink it new in the kingdom of God." Then after singing a hymn, they went out to the Mount of Olives. My brothers and sisters, the gospel of the Lord. What we look for is usually what we find. If I go into a situation and meet someone I've heard a lot about, if I'm looking to find what's wrong with those people, I'll find it. If I've heard great things about them and looking to find what's good about those people, I'll find it. And so our perception prepares us to find what we're looking for. How many of you, in preparation for Mass today, said, "I need Jesus. I need to go receive him. I need Jesus inside of me.
I need him, body and blood, soul and divinity. I need Christ to be part of me and in me. The situation that I'm dealing with at work, home, the office, children, you name it. I need Jesus Christ to come to me. Most of us don't prepare for Mass that way. But in reality, that's what we are doing. When we come here to celebrate the Mass, we're not coming because the singing is good or bad. We're not coming because you like my sermons or dislike my sermons. We're not coming because the stained glass, which you can't see right now because of the rain, looks real pretty. We're coming for the Lord, Jesus Christ, body and blood, soul and divinity. And how many of us think that I'm going to go home, go back to work, go back to my children, go back to my grief, go back to my addiction, go back to my loss, and now Jesus is going with me. And he's going to give me what I need. As we celebrate the feast of Corpus Christi, as Christians and as Catholics, we celebrate something unique to our tradition. If you remember as a child, if you happened to be at a camp on a Sunday, they would say, okay, how many of you are Catholic and how many of you are Protestant? They didn't say how many are Catholic, Baptist, Lutheran, Methodist, Presbyterian. We Catholics were a brand all of our own. And the reason why they separated us was based on our theology of the Eucharist. And people have said, well, we have a communion service in our church. And indeed, many churches do. A girl that I grew up with, and she's now in her seventh marriage, and she came to see me, and she and her husband are involved in another church. And I said, you know, how can you leave the Eucharist for another church? Oh, she said, we have a communion service. I said, oh, really, what is it? She said, well, at one point the pastor passes around a basket full of bread, and we all take one, and we pass it on to the next person. And I said, good. I said, what do you do with the leftovers? She said, what? I said, well, what do you do with the leftovers? She said, well, I don't know. I guess either throw them away or put them back in the box. And I said, so it's not really Jesus. It's just what you think it is. If it's really Jesus, you don't dump the leftovers or put them in a box of crackers. If it's really Jesus, that's why we genuflect when we come in church. We're in the presence of the Son of God. And we show our reverence for him. That's why we do everything we do in reverence, because of the Eucharist and what we believe about the Eucharist. And the Eucharist was foretold in the Old Testament. If you see in this first panel here on the left, you see the sacrifice of Abraham. If you remember the story, Abraham and his wife, they were a very old couple and they couldn't conceive. And finally, in her old age, she conceived a son, Isaac. And Abraham was so grateful. His world was his son. His wife was restored because she was no longer barren. And at one point, God said, if you love me, sacrifice your son. So, to show his love to God, he says, let's go. And all Isaac knows is we're going up the mountain to do a sacrifice. So Isaac, being the young man, is picking up all kind of wood and putting it on his shoulder, and he's carrying up the wood so they can light the fire for the sacrifice. Little did he know, he was the sacrifice. You see here, the angel of the Lord grabs Isaac's hand. He's proven his love, and then they see a lamb caught in the thicket, and they sacrifice the lamb. And then on the other side, you see the high priest Melchizedek, and he did something different. In the Old Testament, the Passover, which they were celebrating, that was an offering to God. The offering to God were the blood of animals. And when you said we're going to celebrate Passover and we're going to sacrifice a lamb, you didn't sacrifice just any lamb. The lamb had to be perfect. No blemishes, no broken bones. And you didn't just kill it and barbecue it in the backyard. You had to take it to the temple. And at the temple, there was this trough. And you took the lamb, and you took his head over the trough, you slit his throat, you bled the lamb out, and one of your family members was at the end of the trough. He had a gold cup, and he caught the blood of the lamb, and he brought it into the temple and placed it on the altar. After they had offered the sacrifice, then they were able to bring the lamb home and cook it. They didn't do a Cajun microwave, okay? They had to cook it a very special way. They had to take the lamb and spread out the legs like this so that it could cook evenly and be ready. So when John the Baptist sees Jesus and says, "Look, there's the Lamb of God," that wasn't a compliment. "There's the one they're going to kill for us. No longer animals, but they're going to kill him for us that our sins might be forgiven." And therefore, the new sacrifice is what our Lord did tonight. Bread and wine, not the blood of animals. But if you want to understand where our theology of the Eucharist comes from, just read the 6th chapter of St. John's Gospel. He makes the statement, "Unless you eat the flesh of the Son of Man and drink his blood, you will not have life eternal." So when our Lord says, "Take this and eat, this is my body. Take this and drink, this is my blood." Then he says, "Do this in memory of me." If he did not intend that his disciples could turn bread and wine into his body and blood, then there are only 11 people who have eternal life. Our Lord and the people in those rooms. In that room, barring Judas. So the intent when he said, "Take this and eat, this is my body. Take this and drink, this is my blood. Do this in memory of me," so that we too might one day share in everlasting life. You know, you do things for over and over for many years, and the last couple of years, when right before communion, I break the host and I say, "Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sin of the world." That's overwhelming to me. Right now there's a wafer on a paten and some wine and a cruet. Before Mass is over, by the power of the Holy Spirit and the gift that God has given me to me in ordination, it becomes the body and blood of our Lord. If we understood that, if we really understood that, if we believe that with all of our heart, tell me a good reason why we would ever miss Mass. There's no baseball park in the world worth passing up that opportunity. A no fishing trip or no golf game or no any excuse. But that's what we celebrate. The Feast of Corpus Christi. That those of us who are blessed to receive will walk out of here today with Jesus Christ, body and blood, soul and divinity within us. If we believe it, it'll change us. If not, nothing changes. When our Lord was in the upper room, the language of his day was Aramaic. Despite popular opinion, Jesus never spoke English, okay? And the language that he would have used in the upper room was Aramaic. As you know, because of my Lebanese heritage, I'm both a Roman Rite Catholic and a Maronite Rite Catholic. And in the Maronite Rite, the words of consecration are done in Aramaic. The same language that our Lord used in the upper room. So, in deference to today's celebration of the Feast of Corpus Christi, our consecration will be done in Aramaic. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church. Almighty Father, who provides the bread of life and the cup of salvation for all who seek him, we now turn to you in prayer.
That God may continue to protect our holy church and unite her in orthodoxy. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
That those who lead may be guided by the Holy Spirit in seeking God's law. Lord, hear us. That brokenness and conflict within families may be healed and resolved through the gracious mercy of God. Lord, hear us. That nourished by the Eucharist, may we continue to grow ever closer to the heart and mind of Christ. Lord, hear us. For an increase in vocations to priesthood and religious life from our parish and throughout our church. Lord, hear us. That through the intercession of Our Lady of Prompt Succor, may we be spared all storms and destruction during this hurricane season. Lord, hear us. For Charles Risler, Joe Anzalone family, Tyler Craig, Diana Morgan, Charles Risler, Johnny Wales, the email family, Karen Babin, Tommy Thiels, Ethel May and R.E. Amarine, Joseph and Eva Ballard, Glenn and Elizabeth Connor, Rafe Duran Salters, Diana Carmier, Bernadine Nugent, Stephen Maloney, Jimmy Moffat, and Beverly Broussard. The sanctuary light burns this week for Mark Ryu. The adoration light burns this week for Raja Bista. For the intentions we hold in the silence of our hearts and place on the altar of God, Lord, hear us.
And for the repose of the soul of our parishioner Sam Pino, Solaria Cangelosi Renazzo, the mother of Mike Renazzo. Loving God and Father, you invite us to the fullness of life through the body and blood of your Son. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be found acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Grant your church, O Lord, the gifts of unity and peace, whose signs are to be seen in mystery in the offering we here present. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Together let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for at the Last Supper with his apostles, establishing for the ages to come the saving memorial of the cross, he offered himself to you as the unblemished lamb, the acceptable gift of perfect praise. Nourishing your faithful by this sacred mystery, you made them holy so that the human race, bounded by one world, may be enlightened by one faith and united by the bond of charity. And so we approach the altar of your wondrous sacrament, so that, bathed in the sweetness of your grace, we may pass over to the heavenly realities here foreshadowed. Therefore, all creatures, heaven and earth, sing a new song in adoration, as together with the angels we acclaim, Holy, Holy, Holy Lord, God of hosts. Yamo haldak dam ha shodile
En sabilag mobida kadisho tu wadimana will walk toho alo bikidku waldi lohu badiku kades Wakso ya bil tell me dao kado mal sabahul mene kul kum ho no din ita bangero. Den bas no men bo dar dakshem en sabidayo dile dakyo toko sohono dakyo waudi lohu badiku kades ya bil tell me down kadomar sabestar mene Kul kum ho no den ita koso dim diati ki agdalo lam rosai waimen on mono tu waklo sagie Me tel shereo shukono dakto he. Amin kirie leison. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray, partaking in the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity. Excuse me. Together with Francis, our Pope, Michael, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember our brothers and sisters who've fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph, her spouse, the blessed apostles and saints who please you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. at the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done. Give us this day our daily bread, as we forgive those who trespass against us.
And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our day, that by the help of your mercy may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant us peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always. Agnus Dei. Qui toles peccata mundi, miserere
nobis. Qui toles peccata mundi, miserere nobis.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sin of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. You will have the option to receive me. immediately following Mass today.
Everyone's invited over to the Parish Activity Center, the old church. Sister Maricel is leaving us to return to the Philippines. She's not leaving for another 10 days or so, but it'll be our chance to formally thank Sister Maricel and wish her well. We hope you make it for the parish reception immediately following Mass. I know the weather's nasty, but please come. Also, the Vacation Bible School starts tomorrow morning at 9 o'clock in the gym. The Monday Healing Rosary is back again at 9 o'clock at the home of Linda and Devin Holly on tomorrow, Monday morning. And also the ladies the dusters are scheduled to come in at 9 a.m. on Tuesday morning. Let us pray. May receiving this sacrament, O Lord our God, bring us health of body and soul as we confess your eternal Holy Trinity and undivided unity through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. And may Almighty God richly bless you, the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. Amen. Go forth, our Mass is ended. St. Michael the Archangel. Who roam the world seeking the ruin of souls. Lord Jesus Christ, Son of the Father, send your Holy Spirit to guide our nation. May your Holy Spirit dwell in the hearts and minds of your faithful and all who serve as leaders. Keep us faithful to your law. Protect us in our trials. Lead us to walk in your word and your love. For the Virgin Mary conceived without sin, may we be spared of all destruction and harm from the devil. Mary, Queen of Nations, Sacred Heart of Jesus, Immaculate Heart of Mary, Sacred Heart of Jesus,